What's going on, everybody? Daniel.
Steven.
And yeah, we're here. As you can see, the camera is eye level. So that means we're doing something that's lower than what we normally like to do. And that's the pay-per-view predictions for the current WWE product.
It's beneath us.
It really is. In fact, we should have the camera down lower. We should be lording over it. But, it's not getting crazy. So anyways, Steve, the last event ended in a little bit of controversy.
Mm-hmm.
You try to fucking cheat on me. It's all right. It's cool.
I cheated.
You're trying
you
to
fucking
you know,
cheated.
Get an extra
you
point in there.
Cheated.
You're like, let's start counting pre-show matches.
Well, it was on your list.
It's all right. You
they
know,
might have bumped it to the pre-show, but it was on your list.
I did the right thing. I stopped you from cheating. So, anyways, we're having the rematch. Elimination Chamber.
Okay.
So, once again, the rules are as follows. I'll go through the matches. We'll go back and forth.
Uh-huh.
We'll give our predictions of who's going to win.
Sure.
For each match we get right, that's a point.
Okay.
And then, of course, at the end of the day, we'll see who had the most wins, which we all know it's going to be this guy. And, we'll...
Don't let him bullshit. Yeah, you know I'm going to win.
And, we'll just go from there. So, my man... We're going to start things off with Randy Orton and Luke Harper. Now, I took the lead last time because... but you know what? I'm going to be generous this time. Tell me, who do you think is going to win between Randy Orton and Luke Harper?
Orton.
You want to add a little bit to that?
Well, I don't think they're going to let Harper beat Orton after Orton just fucking winning the Rumble.
Yeah.
They're not gonna basically kill his push until at least WrestleMania.
Yeah,
you know.
All right.
He may not even win the title at Mania.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying.
But you definitely think his momentum's gonna carry until Mania.
It's gonna carry until Mania.
I'm gonna have to agree with you on that one. I think that match is a lock. I will say this. I like the idea of Harper winning. I do.
It would be nice because they'd be building building another guy.
Well,
you know
I think
what I mean? Actually a talented guy.
No, absolutely.
You know?
I think not only are you building a guy though, it'd be how he would win. Now, I'm not saying a straight up clean victory, but definitely have Bray interfere, and that can kind of start the tension. Because even though I think logically, how is Bray even trusting Randy at all? Because they had an epic feud. Going into their team-up, I'm sorry, I don't care if it's 2 years down the road, I'll be thinking in the back of my mind, is this motherfucker just waiting until I completely trust him? He is the Viper, for Christ's sake.
Well, they did the same thing with Daniel Bryan a couple years ago. Daniel Bryan basically turned on the Wyatt family.
So, I'm thinking to myself, I just don't see why they're like, honestly, like, I'm glad I do give WWE the props for actually stretching the story out, or storyline out.
Mm-hmm.
They're normally known for having the storyline take place within the month and then cut that shit off and go on to the next feud. So I give them props for actually having the storyline because this is actually one of the best things on SmackDown, in my opinion, right now.
I don't care for the Wyatt family.
I love the Wyatt family. Anybody who's chunky like me and is a contender and actually is a damn good wrestler to boot, I mean... He kept up your boy Daniel Bryan at the Rumble.
I'm a Chuck Chaser too, but...
Well, you're teaming with me, obviously. I mean, come on. But back to the point I'm trying to make is...
I can't wait to see him go up against Owens.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Bray Wyatt go up against Owens in like an Extreme Rules match.
I'd be down with that. But back to this
violent.
This right here.
Okay.
But I think it would add more to... Wyatt Orton's dissension. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Like, this would kind of add to the mix. Funny thing is, Eric Rowan's supposed to be coming back at some point. He's been cleared. I'm just waiting for, you know, and I'm kind of curious, like, when he returns, how's he going to fit into all this? And I kind of think it'd be kind of neat. I don't know if he's planning, I don't know, nothing's been official yet. It's all just whatever. But it'd be really neat to see if he came back at Elimination Chamber, where he would fit in. Would he join Harper's side? Because Harper's kind of the lone one right now. Would it be kind of, I don't know, it'd just neat.
If the feud starts, I think they're going to wait until Orton and Bray Wyatt feud starts before they probably
break off. Yeah, no, I hear you. I got you. But like I said, there's just so many things. But I think right now, WWE is definitely going to play it safe. I don't think they're going to throw any curveballs at us right now. Even though there's plenty of room to do it. And once again, everybody is... everybody has their WrestleMania card locked in, and I'm not saying that's not what's going to happen, but I feel like the road there can change. And you got room for change. And that's the thing, like, everybody likes to think that once you go from Royal Rumble to WrestleMania, that it's just like, it's got to go one way. And really, it doesn't. You can go back and look. I mean, I can't say for the past 10 years, but when I was watching it, you had plenty of opportunities to change shit up along the way. Yeah. And they did. But, you know, once again, I think for right now, and in fact, I won't win this title, I'm going to go Orton because, let's face it, I think it's the safe bet. Handicap match. Apollo Crews and Kalisto versus Dolph Ziggler. I'm going to say right now, Ziggles is going to win it. Adolf Ziggles is going to win because...
You call him Adolf Ziggler, yeah, too?
Because I think it doesn't make sense to have the other two guys win because it's like they're trying to build Dolph up.
Yeah.
So it doesn't make sense to have him lose now.
Just job to Kalisto and
Even though he's been jobbing those two guys for a while on TV, I feel like a pay-per-view, he has to win. So I'm going Dolph Ziggler on this one.
Ziggler too.
You're going Ziggler as well.
So I'd be dumb if I didn't because
just I guess the
Ziggler has a better name than Kalisto and what's it, that old boy.
Now don't get me wrong, I could see them winning because hey, that makes them look incredibly weak too if they lose to one guy. So I could see them winning, but then Ziggler attacking him afterward, or someone even brought up, I want to say maybe Steven Larson or one, you know, I don't know which one, but on the show I was listening to, that maybe even someone can interfere and help Ziggler out, or maybe even come in afterwards, and you can still have them win the match, because it would make sense to have two guys beat one without making them look like a couple of pussies.
Off subject, which show do you think Angle's going to go to for WrestleMania? Off subject. I just
no idea. Is he going to go to a different show? I know he's wanting to, and I know he's going to be in the Hall of Fame, but is he going to wrestle? Because that's the thing. Like, no one knows if he's going to be cleared to wrestle by then.
Shit, that'd be hellacious.
Oh, don't get me wrong. I'm down. I prefer him with SmackDown just because that's where the wrestling's at, obviously.
And SmackDown, he basically made a name on SmackDown.
That and Styles don't really have anything that looks like for WrestleMania, so if you let that open for Styles and Angle, that'd be awesome.
From what I heard, he has some hellacious matches with Styles in TNA.
So, all right, let's move on now. Mickie James versus Becky Lynch, and I'll let you take the lead on this one. Mickie James versus Becky Lynch. Becky James. So who do you think's gonna?
I'd go with Mickie.
Go on Nikki on that one. What's your reason?
Because I don't think they're really actually wanting to do anything with Becky right now. Mm-hmm. She's probably just gonna have her job out, and they're just gonna build Mickie James back up because she's like one of them, like, what do they call that? Upper tier talents.
Yeah. As far as
the Divas go, she's more or less an upper tier talent.
No, absolutely.
They're wanting to give her a little.
She has a little bit more name recognition, a little more weight to her name. Okay. You know, honestly,
you're gonna go with Becky.
I'm gonna go with Becky. Now, don't get me wrong. This is one of those matches where I could see it going either way. And honestly, initially, I was actually going Mickie James because I feel like, hey, this is her. Even though I'm shocked that she lost. At the last one, of course, it didn't count because it was on pre-show.
Well, she lost on NXT.
They don't count any of us on the main roster either, because all those guys who are awesome there that come to the WWE, they suck. So it don't fucking matter. Anyways,
they don't know what to fucking do with them when they come up.
Agreed. Well, no one wants to get up the spot. So, even though I think the smart money would be on Mickie James, because I'm like, this is her first singles match on pay-per-view. Mm. Why make her lose? But some reason, I just feel like
they did do it to AJ Styles in his first.
I know, that's what I'm saying. And I gotta say,
of course, WWE fucks over pretty much every single TNA guy in their first match.
So I gotta say, I'm gonna go Becky Lynch mainly because I feel like I don't want to see her get knocked down too much. I feel like not that I want to see another Alexis versus Becky Lynch match at WrestleMania, but I feel like we gotta keep Becky up in that thing. So I'm gonna go Becky Lynch just because. And once again, it's one of those things where this is that one where this is risky. I'm rolling the dice on this one, but I'm gonna go Becky Lynch on this one, just because I feel like it's almost safer to have her, even though I think it makes more sense to have Mickie James, but when's the last time WWE actually made sense of anything? Come on. I'm going to go Becky Lynch on that one. So, we got our first one we disagreed on. So, okay. I was kind of afraid we were going to go through this whole thing agreeing, because I think we kind of have the same mindset when it comes to this pay-per-view, but I'm going to disagree on this one. So, we got our split finally. We got our split. So,
okay.
No coin toss on this one. All right. So, We're going ahead now to the women's title, Alexa Bliss versus Naomi. I'm going to say Alexa Bliss on this one. Not that I'm surprised. I don't know a lot of these wrestlers. I don't watch the product. And I'm sorry, if I see Naomi's name on a video, I don't click on it. Because I don't know who it is. Yeah. All I know is that she used to dance. Was she like with the Funkasaurus thing? Was she one of those girls? So I just like don't care. Now, since she's been kind of in this thing with Alexa Bliss, I did get, like, Bliss got on my radar. I was watching her and Becky Lynch, and I was impressed with what I saw. So I was kind of paying attention to this. I don't think Naomi's going to win the title at all. But I think she's going to be groomed and pushed eventually. Could she have a title run down the road? I don't know. I think she's going to be taken more seriously after this. After watching her on this past SmackDown, I was really impressed with what I saw. And I think, you know what? The crowd's definitely behind her. And that's one thing that really surprised me. I was like, and I guess it shouldn't surprise me because I don't watch the product at all, so I don't know how the crowd should react. But I guess the fact that I just didn't know who she was at all and saw her and get to, you know, and once when she fucking kicked the shit right out of her, I was like, you know what? And she can wrestle, and I'm like, you know what? She surprised me. I guess I was expecting, because you gotta realize when I left WWE, you did have some good talent wrestlers, but then you also had a lot of divas. You know, for every, like, Trish Stratus or Lita or Mickey James you had, you also had a Tori Wilson or a Stacy Keibler. So it just, it was a bad mix bag. And I just kind of threw Naomi into that shit bag. Like, she's just tits and ass, and that's it. And when I saw her,
not just tits and ass, she's a whole lot of ass.
But she's a pretty good wrestler, too. Now, tonight or tomorrow night,
I agree.
She's not going to be her night. Wrestler, but I think she will eventually get up there. Now, hopefully, this will be her launching pad. Because I don't know what the woman's title, or at least the SmackDown woman's title picture is going to be like at WrestleMania. And I really don't want to just throw everybody together. But at the same time, it's like, a fatal four-way would be pretty good with talking James Lynch, Bliss, and Naomi.
Yeah.
But so I'm going Bliss on this one. What about you?
Well, I said I was going with Bliss. Okay. Yeah.
So you're going and reason?
Reason, because I don't think they're going to push what's her name yet.
Naomi just yet. Yeah, I agree. Well, not just that, but just Bliss is doing good as a champion. I mean, she's a heel that you're rooting against. You want to see her lose. So you got something working like that, keep her there. Tag team turmoil, and I don't really want to throw all the tag teams. I went through the names with you earlier. You know who's all in the tag turmoil. Who do you think's going to win it?
I'm going to go with Alpha.
American Alpha. And give me your reason.
They haven't been champions for long. And they probably won't take the belts off them anytime soon.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's what I'm guessing. Until at least WrestleMania or something like that.
Gotcha.
A bigger pay-per-view.
Yeah. Yeah, I agree. I'm going with American Alpha too. And really, same thing. I mean, I'm not saying that they would never do that because they've done that before. They've given the title to somebody and then just took it away from them, like, you know, the next night or whatever. But I feel like they have a very weak tag division. And just because you have a lot doesn't mean it's great. Mm-hmm. And they've proven that on both shows, in my opinion, because when you just have multiple 12-man tag teams, I'm sorry, that's a sign of a bad division. When you can't actually give every tag team their own storyline and give them their own matches. Look at the women. There are three women's matches on here, which is a great sign. That means there's actually three different storylines within a small women's group. There is nothing like that going in the tag division. It's literally just like, oh, we have some tag teams.
Yeah,
fucking throw them together. Now,
of course, Vince McMahon hates small men and tag teams.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's evident right here. And thing is, I'm glad they're doing it here and not WrestleMania. Although I feel like American Alpha is a tag team that would get bumped to the pre-show, unfortunately.
Yeah.
I don't see them having a solid tag match at WrestleMania. If they do, it'll be pre-show or they'll just be a part of the fucking Battle Royal. But anyways, to me, it'd just be stupid to take titles off of them. Not just that, who would they drop it to? Even though they did have Ascension win the last big tag match everybody had,
Ascension they're not giving sucks.
It to Ascension. It's just not. To me, they're
a joke tag team.
Wasn't they awesome in NXT?
Not really.
Your NXT?
I didn't care for them.
Oh, you loved them.
I didn't.
But no, I agree with the American Alpha, so. Nikki Bella versus Natalya. I'm going to have to go with Nikki Bella on this one. Hold your horses. We'll go back and forth. My main reason is, and I know your reason is probably going to be like, well, she's fucking John Cena. My reason is, right now, it's rumored
they've
that
always shit on the Hart family.
Okay, that too, but no,
pretty much that's what it is. They've always shit on the Hart
family. My reason is a little more in depth than that. rumor has it that they're wanting to build up a mixed tag match at WrestleMania. John Cena, Nikki Bella versus Miz and Maryse. You wouldn't have, and it's supposed to be Nikki Bella's last match. She's going to be retiring. So if that's the case, I'm not saying I'm looking forward to the match one way or another. I'm just saying if that's the case, I don't see them having her lose this match to push her. Because as far as I can see, the tag don't have shit after this.
Yeah.
I don't, and unless they do some kind of fucked up mini women's battle royal or five-way clusterfuck, I don't see Natalya really doing anything at WrestleMania. No. And it's unfortunate because I think she should, but at the same time, it's like, as far as her story goes, it doesn't make sense. So so I'm going to say Bella just because I think that since she does have WrestleMania plans, you wouldn't have her lose here. And not just that, but even though this storyline is a little ridiculous, I ain't going to lie, I have not been clicking on these videos when I do my WWE highlight look. Not. Just because it just seems like bad attitude era writing. It's just like, you know, your man don't love you. He ain't going to marry you. He ain't going to put a ring on that finger. It's just like, I don't give a shit. Like, that's really your feud now? Like, if Natalya was just like, listen, it's ridiculous that I'm a wrestler and you're just here for sleeping with John Cena and the fact that you're getting more time on TV than I am and I'm actually talented, that makes more sense. And I'd be like, yes, that's a feud I want to see. Mm-hmm. Unfortunately, it's just, yo, man. And I'm just like, I'm done. So so you're saying Bella as well?
Bella, yeah.
And you want to elaborate on this, or is that pretty much your...
Pretty much it.
That's it. Alrighty. And then, of course, we've got the Elimination Chamber for the WWE World Champion. They call it World Champion, or is it just WWE Champion? It don't matter. It's like a fucking joke anyways. John Cena, AJ Styles, Dean Ambrose, The Miz, Baron Corbin, and Bray Wyatt. Take it away.
Since John Cena became a 16-time World Champion, I'm thinking they're probably going to take the belt off of John Cena because John Cena's going to be retiring. He's also going to be retiring soon as well. Yeah. I'm thinking they're going to put the belt around Bray.
Mm-hmm. So you're going Bray
to build up a match with Orton.
Yeah. Just didn't know if you don't keep going. No, I agree. That's the overwhelmingly popular opinion right now. And just because, and this is what I do hate. Like, if I was actually a wrestling fan, I would just hate being a wrestling fan today because
it sucks.
Every fucking, and I guess we're contributing to it, but it's like everybody knows everything already. Like, everybody knows what the WrestleMania card is pretty much going to look like.
Yeah.
The fact that it's looking like Cena and Nikki Bella going against Miz and Maryse. It's looking like Ambrose and Corbin for the Intercontinental title. Once again, Styles doesn't factor in, and it just makes you wonder if maybe they are holding back for Angle. Because once again, I haven't heard anything about Angle. Everything I hear about Angle, it's like he wants to compete. He's going to be there for the Hall of Fame, but they've yet to say, you can wrestle. Like, he hasn't been cleared yet by their doctors. You know how that goes. Right, Dale Bryan? So right now, Styles really has nothing. And of course, the question is, like, could it be him... Like, they're wanting to say, like, maybe a triple threat at some point. Like, maybe he's going to insert himself somehow into the, you know, I don't know. And once again, there's so much can happen between now and then. You could have, because once again, it's not like a set in stone or Orton's going to fight the champion. Even though it is, you could have him lose a match where it's like, you know, put your shot up next week, you know, and then he loses. That can happen. That's not like it hasn't happened before. Christ's sake. Look at WrestleMania 2000. Look at WrestleMania 2000. From Royal Rumble 2000 until WrestleMania 2000, that was the biggest clusterfuck of multiple changes until we got a fatal four-way with McMahon in every corner. If that doesn't prove that shit can happen between Royal Rumble and WrestleMania, I don't know what does. However, WWE's playing it safe right now. I don't see them throwing a whole lot of curveballs. I can see Styles being inserted at some point into any match just because, A, he's a good wrestler, but, B, he has nothing going on right now. Like, if he loses this match, where does he go exactly? Would Orton versus Styles be a good match physically? Yeah, be a damn good match.
Mm-hmm.
Storyline-wise, it doesn't really make sense. And even though I guess you can cheer either man, they're still heels. Even though, yes, I would be cheering Styles hardcore, you know, essentially, he's a heel. You don't want heel versus heel at WrestleMania for a title.
No.
The smart money's Wyatt, because, once again, I just feel like WWE is going to play way too safe. I don't see them throwing too many curveballs right now with so many questions and, you know, so many things in the air right now. I feel like this is going to be a very safe pay-per-view. I don't see this really breaking any new ground or going differently. And from our voting, we kind of see that as well. Once again, the only match we disagreed on was Mickie James and Becky Lynch. Keep in mind, right now, that if any, now once again, I think the pre-show match is Kurt Hawkins and somebody, whoever the hell he's feuding with. He bumped into somebody backstage, I think, and they're like, we're having a match. So that's the pre-show match right now that, remember, that happened last time. So if any of these matches get bumped to the pre-show, like if Mickie James and Becky Lynch gets bumped to the pre-show, that means we're going to tie everything else, and the title stays vacant, and I still got a chance to be the first ever champion. That's the rules, Steve. That's the rules. So, but you know it ahead of time. Don't
the
be
Burger
crying.
King crown doesn't mean anything to
me. Oh, it's going to mean.
Just kicking your ass is all that matters.
It's going to happen. It's going to be this guy right here. But right now, that's it. Right now, we agree on every fucking match except for Mickie James and Becky Lynch. So, we'll have to see what happens. So,
and, of course, I haven't been watching the product, neither.
No, there you go.
Other than 205 and NXT, that's it.
He's like, I love the indies. Dang it, Brian.
You do too, fuckface.
I love the indies.
You too. WCPW guy.
She's right. See, you see the hairstyle. This was from, I just got to do my True Destiny review over here. So, alrighty, well, that's it. So, I guess until... Well, I guess Sunday night. Well, we won't be seeing you guys Sunday night. We'll be doing this Wednesday, so I guess until Wednesday when you see this guy crown the first ever prediction champion. I'll see you at my coordination.
Read between the lines.